Have you ever wondered how tap water gets from a lake all the way to your glass? And why it doesn't taste like lake? It actually takes a lot more steps than you might think. So, let's see them for ourselves. Wow, that's good. Come on. This is a river, one of the places where we can get our drinking water. But currently, there's like leaves and sticks and stuff in here, not to mention germs and other microscopic nasties. So it's still a long way from being ready to drink. The first step to treating your water is having it collected here and putting it into a pipe and then being sent to treatment. The surface water will be screened to remove large items, such as leaves, sticks, and even fish. Once it's in a pipe, the water is taken to a drinking water treatment facility. No matter where you live in Utah, there's a water treatment facility somewhere nearby.
Should you be doing this interview while driving?
Oh, it's perfectly safe. Oh, it's right here. The water treatment plant. I know, it's a big concrete building. But just like a good burrito, the inside's a lot more interesting. The first step at the water treatment plant is called preoxidation. Ozone and other sanitizing chemicals are added to the water to break down large organic molecules that come off of things like decaying vegetation. This gets rid of nasty taste and odors right off the bat. Essentially, ozone, which is supercharged, wants to give away oxygen molecules to other compounds, which breaks them down. The water then goes to these basins, where it goes through a process called coagulation and flocculation. And if it sounds funny, it's because it kind of is. Let me show you a detailed look of what's happening. Coagulation is when treatment chemicals are added to the water, which forms microscopic particles around unclean things that need to be removed from the water. Unfortunately, these things are too small to easily remove. That's why we need flocculation. In flocculation, the water is stirred so that these microscopic particles collide and form larger particles, called floc, that will gently settle out of the water. See? These are floc. I know the water looks gross at this point, but in order to get the small nasties out of the water, we need to round them all up with these larger particles. Next comes sedimentation. Essentially, the water is slowed down and these big floc naturally settle out on plate settlers. All of that is happening in here, right now, as we speak, just on a much larger level. All of those steps are to prepare for filtration. All the water passes through a physical filter where the rest of the microscopic particles are trapped and removed. All that's left to do is add a small amount of chlorine to protect the pipes and keep the water clean as it travels to your home. Now the water is all clean and ready to drink. Our water treatment plant stores millions of gallons of water, just in case of an emergency. And the rest gets sent through the pipes to your school and neighborhood. All to come out right here. Ta-da! So, the next time you take a drink, you can be thankful for all the hard work that got it from a lake into your glass.